Let's focus on one of Filterscape's distinctive features, the Morphing EQ. It's the beating heart of all three Filterscape plugins, FX, Q6, and VA. While there are slight differences between the three, they share a common concept. You can recall, automate, and morph up to 8 snapshots, each with individual EQ settings. Both global and per snapshot modulation are available for each band. This is where Filterscape's envelope followers really shine. Let's dive into the key features of the Morphing EQ. In the upper third of the interface, you'll find 3 sections: snapshot controls, EQ graphic editor, and band parameters. The snapshot section has 8 selectors arranged in a circle. Click any of the numbers to select a snapshot for editing. You can morph between snapshots by clicking and dragging the inner part of the dial. The snapshot position is indicated by a white line. The green curve represents snapshot settings, while the grey curve represents the actual modulated settings. Double-click on a snapshot to set the morph position. The auto mode allows automatic snapshot scanning. Choose a time base and then pick forward or bi-directional mode. The snapshots will be scanned in sync with the host tempo, the current position being indicated by the little green pip. Adjust start and loop parameters to set the starting point and loop length. You can also modulate the snapshot position using various modulation sources. Click on the selector and choose a source, such as LFO1. This works with or without auto mode. The little green pip shows the actual modulated snapshot position. Both global gain and snapshot gain have their own modulation options. And finally, the interpolate function creates smooth transitions between start and target snapshots. The EQ graphic editor allows you to adjust gain and frequency by left-clicking and dragging the desired band for the selected snapshot. Right-click to adjust the Q value and hold Shift for fine adjustments. Holding Control or Option lets you group adjust all 4 bands. Right-click anywhere to choose between 5 EQ modes, for example, the 4 bandpasses mode. Under preset formants, we've included the most common formant frequencies for vocal filtering. In the top right, the band parameters offer in-depth control and modulation possibilities. There are 4 columns, one for each EQ band. Each band lets you modulate its frequency and gain, both globally and snapshot-wide. Of course, there's a manual control for Q, which is the steepness of the curve, aka filter quality. For our first example, we've got a Fender Rhodes type electric piano by Arturia. It's dry and without any effects. Let's look at creating 3 different effects for individual snapshots and how we can morph between them. Snapshot 1 is blank, for reasons I'll explain later. Snapshot 2 has a slight bump in the high mids and a trough around 200 Hz. Routing LFO2 to snapshot gain provides a nice tremolo effect. Looking at Snapshot 3, here's a phaser style EQ setting with a high Q factor for all four bands. LFO1 sweeps the frequencies of all bands, creating a typical swoosh effect. Remember, you can change the modulation depth and polarity individually for each of the four bands. You can also tweak the gain scale to fine-tune the strength of the EQ, even inverting it if you like. Looking at Snapshot 4, this is basically an auto-wah with a bit of added auto-phaser. The wah effect is achieved by envelope follower 1 controlling the frequency of band 2. Bands 3 and 4 are being swept by LFO1 with opposite polarities, adding some nice movement. We can now turn the center wheel to morph between the three settings. First, let's jump to Snapshot 1, which has a flat EQ curve and no modulation. We can now turn the center wheel to morph between the three settings. Morphing into the empty Snapshot 5, we're effectively fading out the effect. Of course, you can record the movements of the Snapshot morph position as automation data in your DAW. Or activate the auto mode. Or use the Snapshot modulation. To demonstrate what can be achieved with the envelope followers, let's take this beat. I've already tweaked the EQ settings for the first four snapshots quite a bit. Now, what if we used an envelope follower to modulate the snapshot position? Start with a moderate amount of modulation to hear the effects while fine-tuning the envelope followers. Next, adjust the input attenuation, but beware of clipping. A and R stand for attack and release, and these two knobs control the shape of the envelope. When the type is set to signal, the envelope is controlled by the unaltered input signal. Alternatively, you can choose from three filters to modify the envelope follower's detection path. For instance, selecting band pass will help isolate specific components of our drum loop. Let's start by focusing on the bass drum. Lowering the cutoff frequency to pick out the low end is a good start. Setting a high value for the smooth parameter will remove any unwanted jitter. Now, you have a configuration that produces a smooth AR envelope whenever the bass drum hits. Adjusting the filter cutoff, threshold, and attenuation parameters will allow us to single out the rimshot instead. Since we have four envelope followers at our disposal, we can mix and match them for different tasks. Here, for example, we use envelope follower 1 to modulate the snapshot position with the bass drum. And envelope follower 2 to affect the second band in the second snapshot with the rimshot. This way, you can configure up to four envelope followers for various purposes at the same time. We'll now take a look at Q6, the 6-band version of Filterscape, with a focus on envelope followers. I've chosen the preset Drum Loop D-Transient to showcase the dynamic EQ skills of Q6. As you can hear, there are lots of transients in this dry, unprocessed signal. Turning up the gain scale control will bring the detransient effect to the fore. Band 3, controlled by envelope follower 3, is doing the heavy lifting here. So let's solo it by deactivating the other three envelope followers. The gain of band 3 is decreased by about 16 dB. Envelope follower 3 modulates that gain back upwards. Every time the envelope follower fires, the gain of band 3 increases. The shorter the attack, the more transients will pass. A longer release ensures that enough of the post-transient signal is allowed through. Let's bring back the other three envelope followers. Again, the gain scale control can be used to adjust the strength of the morphing EQ. In the negative range, unexpected results may occur. In this case, the effect is literally reversed, with the transients being exaggerated. Remember, each snapshot can have its own EQ and modulation settings. A great way of breathing some life back into heavily squished material. Feel free to tweak the envelope follower controls for some interesting results. Finally, this is Filterscape VA, the virtual analog synth with a polyphonic morphing EQ, one for each synth voice. Let's take the composite preset, which makes good use of the four-band passes filter mode. In this preset, the principal modulation source for the EQ bands is the arpeggiator, or more accurately, the mod track, a freely routable modulation sequencer tied to the arpeggiator. But first, let's reduce the delay effect a little. Now, increasing the Q factors of bands 1 and 3 will make them stand out more. And just some slight changes to band 2 and the low pass filter. Next, we'll modulate band 3 with the ARP mod by a negative amount. And now, for the icing on the cake, we'll use one of the options to autofill the remaining 7 snapshots. Let's pick Sweep. This will simply shift all EQ bands gradually from left to right up to snapshot 8. So here's the trick. We'll modulate the snapshot position with the same ARP mod track that's already modulating the EQ bands. You can tweak the mod track while it's running. So that's it for now. Have fun experimenting and check out our Filterscape preset walkthroughs for more inspiration. Bye.